You know, all that business with Vic and his cat. Well, they're here to hear our story this year.
Oh, what's that then?
It is the tale of the beauty sleeping.
Hey!
Hey! Why are you standing like that?
I'm being heroic.
I love you, baby. Look right here.
Getting upset. Sturdy chopper.
Yes, you might see.
What's the matter, dear?
I am troubled, my dear wife. For a long time now, I have been disturbed. You know, for a long time now I'd hoped that when I leave this green and pleasant land, that an heir would take my throne.
Where do you want to take it?
I mean an heir to take my place.
Where do you want to take it?
Oh, plop! Stop! Stop! Stop!
What do you mean? Always trying to have a beautiful daughter, a handsome son. Take over when we're gone. Where are you going?
Ooh, my baby's home. That's why we need someone to take over so we can go away and top up our
Well, I could use my clairvoyant capabilities.
Pardon?
I could utilise my precognitive prowess.
Ooh, come again?
I can tell the future.
Oh? Yes, you can look into the future so we can have a children of our own.
Give me a second.
What can you see?
Lots and lots and lots of darkness. Oh, hang on. I see a beautiful woman. She's dressed in pink and wears a crown. She's eating a bowl of Weetabix Crunch.
Ah! That's who ate the last of the packet, is it? Who is it?
This is 15 years in the future and it's your daughter.
Oh, that's wonderful, Louise.
Something else weighs heavy on my mind.
That crown. No wonder I've never got any ibuprofen left.
No, this is important. I've just invented the sock, but I don't know how to make one, and my feet are cold walking on these stone castle floors.
What's a sock, dear?
Well, it's like a hat, but you wear it on your foot.
Then you can have one hot foot. And one cold foot. What an amazing invention.
No. You'd have one for each foot, obviously. I just need somebody to make them for me.
Oh, there's a woman in the village who makes jumpers. Maybe she could help. And maybe you could change the name to Foot Jumpers.
That is a splendid idea, Plop. Get yourself down to the village straight away and see if this lady will make these foot jumpers for me, and that would make me even richer.
A fruit cake is rich, but is it truly happy?
Right. Before you go, Plop, do you think you could use your fortune-telling powers to tell me who's going to be the 3:30 at Chepstow this afternoon?
Jeff! What did I say? Off you go,
Doctor.
Yes, Jeff, isn't it wonderful, dear? We're going to have a little girl.
Yes, it's wonderful, dear, but I really have got no idea how to go about it.
Aldi, it's due for 1 on tins of broad beans. And I entered the Interwitch over exaggeration competition and won for the 100th millionth time. Anyway, that's not why I'm here. When I'm not busy protecting the kingdom from the bad witch of the South, Hoffman, I'm doing other nice things for people and making their dreams come true.
Don't.
light of the shadow, by the darkness of the sun, by the bays that wobble and a lightly flowered burn, by the hammer of Thor and a tank top of love, by the icicle that melts and a small child's glove, by the crunchy nut cornflakes and a cod with six fins, bless this here woman with a fine set of twins.
I thought you said a mild tickle. I felt the earth move there for the first time. In 15 years. How long is this? Baby business.
9 months.
Nine months! That's almost a year! That's longer than it takes to do a baby jigsaw puzzle. What am I going to do until then? My husband took all the money, the pets, the jars of salmon paste, and my electric trout. How am I going to feed their little mouths? I've only got one room. I could have them build an extension, and they're not cheap. I've seen homes under the hammer.
Well, you're going to have to find some way of raising the cash. Also, it takes balls to raise children. Do you have balls? Now, Cogburn, the bad witch of the south, is going around casting spells on all newborn babies, so you must take care. Now, if you see Cogburn, the bad witch of the south, I want you all to boo. Can you do that for me?
Yes!
Shall we have a little practice?
Yes!
On three. One, two, three!
Boo!
Now, you're going to know who she is because she has really long dark hair and she wears a pointy hat and she's green. Now, Mrs. Droopy, if you see Cogburn, you can call for me by yodeling and I'll rush to your aid.
Should you come here instead?
That's what I mean.
Hey, right, okay. Yodeling? How do I do that?
Oh, it's easy. My helpers will show you.
Lay your
more weighing to do. The kitchen sink is in the right state, and I need
there's money in it.
Come in. Have a cup of. Yes. Well, how can I help?
Well, His Royal Highness King Jeff of Malden has invented the foot jumper, and he wants you to make him some. He'll pay you one gold coin per pair.
Ooh, well, this is wonderful news. I'll be able to feed the kids, pay the rent, and buy a large pair of replacement electric trousers.
Pardon?
Yes, a large pair of replacement electric trousers.
No, the bit before that.
Pay the rent.
No, the bit before that.
Feed the kids.
Yeah, what kids?
Oh, didn't I tell you? I'm pregnant.
How did that happen?
The good witch Betty was casting baby spells, and now I have a couple of buns and a very, very large oven.
Where's Betty now?
I don't know.
The king and queen want an heir to their throne. If Betty is going around casting baby spells on people, she could cast one on them.
Oh. I don't know. Do you know where Betty went? No. Well, how are we going to find her?
There you go!
Do you know the yodel plot?
Well, I can try, but I think we need the boys and girls to help us.
Yes, I think you're right. Okay, after three, let's have your best yodel. One, two, three! Yay! Well, surprisingly, actually, which now makes this small speech I prepared about how poor you are almost seem not worthwhile, but I'm going to say it anyway. I was going to say, don't be embarrassed yodeling in front of people you don't know, because let's get some context in here. We don't get paid, do we, context? Yeah. Don't we? We don't. Don't give the Lord of their weddings. Right, anyway, come on then, let's have another year. We'll see if we get Benny out. After three, one, two, three!
Yeah. Where is she? Come here, you nasty green witch woman.
Betty.
Don't do that! You'll give me palpitisms!
No, you give me palpitations.
That's what I said. Where is this nasty hogbill anyway?
That's not what we called you for. The king and queen require your assistance.
I'm not at home to miss the shenanigans. I'm a very busy woman. I've got to make the kids' teas, hoover my curtains, wash my octopus.
There's money in it.
I have to do.
They want an heir to their throne, and Mrs. Droopy here said you were going around casting baby spells on people. So we thought maybe you could...
What?
You know, you can do the mild tingle.
No, I'm not with you.
You can cast a baby spell on the
girls. But I only have one spell left, and it's for a very special girl. She's going to be the most beautiful woman in the kingdom.
Oh, who's it for?
See who it's for. Oh, I need my glasses.
That's all right, I'll read it for you. Oh, Jem and Bridget, that's the king and queen. Off you go, then.
No, I shouldn't read it. Has anybody seen my glasses? Jeff Bridges?
Oh, no, it definitely says Jeff and Bridget.
Oh, well, if you're sure.
Yeah, come on, I'll take you there.
Bye, boys and girls.
Bye. Right, okay, now, what was it that I was doing? Oh, yes. My husband left me.
Shush, Tinkle.
So, Pop ran back from the castle, dragging Betty the Good Witch behind him.
They got to the castle, and Betty cast a spell on Queen Bridget.
Oh, and at last the king and queen had an heir to their throne, a daughter who would one day be queen herself.
This is a nice story, isn't it, boys and girls?
Yes!
Yes, but like all good pantomimes, there's a twist.
Ooh! What? Chubby Jack is in it?
Hogbin, the bad witch in the south.
The laugh sounds exactly like that. Yeah. You won't forget to boo now, will you, boys and girls? Yeah. Let's get out of here.
Give me fish.
Oh, shush!
Mr. and Mrs. Pants are having a son. Oh, yes. I'm going to make him support Watford. Mr. and Mrs. Smell are having a daughter. Oh, I'll make her addicted to Love Island. Oh, now, Jeff and Bridget Beauty. Oh, the King and Queen are having a baby. Oh, my dearest friends. Oh, I'm so excited. For them, I shall cast the nicest spell I can find.
Are you feeling all right, Oggy? It's just, well, you don't actually have any nice spells.
Yes, I do. I am actually a lovely person when I want to be.
Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am. On the first day, of the 16th year of her life, she will prick her finger and fall asleep forever.
That does sound quite effective, but you do know that every fairy story that a prince comes and kisses a princess, she wakes up and everyone lives happily ever after, don't you?
Okay, in that case, a huge tangle vine will grow around the castle to stop any Prince Charming getting in and doing any of that smoochy coochy stuff.
Okay, well, now that's out of the way, can I have a milk now?
I'm so happy you can have the whole cow!
Just the milk, thanks.
You fancy the princess?
So do you.
You go all red when they mention her name.
Princess Beauty's all grown up and lives in the castle with her mum, dad, king, queen, and all the courtiers.
Fiddle loves beauty. Fiddle loves beauty.
You fancy her more.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
I don't fancy the princess. Off you go.
Go on. Oh, kids these days. I feel really a bit cheering up all that. Do you know any jokes about witches?
I know 3 jokes about witches.
Let's hear it.
Joke number 1. Why did the witches live together? Because they were roommates.
Wasn't a solid start to the jokes. Let's hope they improve. Number 2, please.
Joke number 2. Why do witches wear name badges?
Why?
So they know which witch is which.
You've really got a nail in this last one, come on.
Did you hear about the witch who bought a cat off the local blacksmith?
No.
As soon as she got it home, it made a box for the door.
We appear to have entered into some common area.
Definitely some commoners here.
Yes, I think it might be your subject. Possibly from Cropwell up this end. I heard it's a progressive village. Best to progress straight through. That's a lovely jumper. Do they sell men's clothes where you got it from? They really do. I'm very worried, Mr. Summerfield. I believe I have a dress that would fit you just right.
Not with heels.
But your mother kept it. Anyway. So, I said to Mr. Faberge, I said, you can't put it up there. And he said, don't worry, it's not my bike, it's the Archbishop's. Well, it just so happened I got a corset with a very large set.
I must say, Mother Trippy, they're much better at making these foot jumpers. Another 16 years and you might just crack it.
Yes, but I've been practicing on my two sons, you see. Now, I've tried the all-in-one body jumper with feet, but Fiddle couldn't see where he's going. And crushed into Tinkle, who was holding a very large cup of rye peanut. Very messy. I had to get the rug doctor out. And then I tried the all-in-one face jumper. But realised the balaclava had all...
Yes, yes, well, whatever. Anyway, I've been selling these on eBay. I've made an absolute fortune.
There's more to life than money, you know.
Like what?
TikTok?
Oh, no, no, no. Oh, I'm not putting it so cruelly.
Yes, Your Majesty. What have you been doing? Running with the chicken and standing with the chicken. We've been thinking about our daughter's wedding. She's 60. I mean, you've got to that plan in the haven't you?
I remember my wedding. My husband wore top hat and tails. He looked so handsome, he did. I shall never forget the day he took me up the aisle.
Forever?
That's ages. Sting is not the X Factor series. And we have
get rid of anything pointy. Needles, pins, pencils.
You won't have to ban Watford.
Why?
They've never got any points!
Banned in the kingdom, how am I going to continue to make foot jumpers?
Good point.
Oh, no, no, I can't have any points.
I have to let you go.
I've got children to feed and Xbox games to buy and having what a merchandise to collect and there are so many wants. It's
sorry, but we can't have any needles or pins in the kingdom. Come on, Eddie. Let's go and have a chit chat and a cup of tea. Mother Trudy, I have an idea. This footjumper business is far too lucrative to let it go under. I mean, look at this. So, I will give you a secret room in the highest part of the castle. Where you can carry on making these foot jumpers. But you must make sure you keep the door locked shut and don't let Beauty in at all.
Yes, of course. Yes, yes. Oh, Mr. King, what a wonderful idea. Then I'll be able to knit until my hands are sore. But Fiddle and Tickle are the best Christmas ever.
Don't tell the wife, will you?
Oh, no, no, no. Mum's the word.
Hello, Mother.
Your father was just asking me what his winning word in Scrabble was the other night. And I said, Mum, what's the word?
Yes, Scrabble. Scrabble,
yes.
What's going on outside?
What do you mean?
I just saw a plop in the street.
Did you clear it up?
Leaving me? No! Your clothes! We're going on holiday!
Oh, no, no, we can't go on holiday! while we're away, and then the prophecy will unfold before our very eyes.
Jeff!
No, we can't go on holiday, no.
We've removed all the pointy things from the kingdom. How could she possibly prick herself?
Well, yes, I suppose so. How could she prick herself if there are no needles? I mean, pointy things in the tower. I mean, kingdom. Yes, they're all right. We'll go to Barbados.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Captain Tobias Wilcox. Welcoming you aboard Coconut Airways Flight 372 to Bridgetown, Barbados. We'll be flying at a height of 32,000 feet and at an airspeed of approximately 600 miles an hour. Refreshments will be served soon after takeoff. Kindly now fasten your seatbelts and refrain from smoking until the aircraft is airborne.
Against knitting, and second of all, you have to do as I say.
in. Right, what we need to do, as your beginner, we'll start with these two bits of wood. Because I wouldn't want you to prick yourself.
I'm not a child anymore, Mother Droopy. Give me the proper needles.
I can't see too fine them. My eyes aren't what they used to be.
What do they used to be? Bananas?
I've been struck by lightning!
Yeah. Beauty has
you two, this is earnest.
No, this is Tinkler and Fiddle.
Shush! She has fallen asleep forever.
How long's that then?
At least 20 years.
She got the needle.
Not surprised being asleep that long.
She had a little brick. Don't even go there. Now, the curse has come true, and it's all my fault. And partially the king's too. But I fear that Queen Bridget will thrash us to within an inch of our lives.
I mean, technically we're metric now, so she'll thrash us to within 25.1
millimetres. Shush. What are we going to do?
Cry uncontrollably? That's all the king next year?
But it's not a very constructive plan. But it's the only one we've got.
Please be upstanding for his and her royal highnesses, the king and queen of the
world. Yes, yes, yes. What's a royal highness to be down? Mother Droopy, we must have some serious words.
Oh, yes, of course. Solemn. Somber. Weighty.
What he means is we need to speak to you about a serious matter. We had an answer phone message. We couldn't understand it. I could hear Wales.
Yes, I've never been able to understand the Welsh.
No, the Wales!
Oh yeah, they make a kind of...
Betsy and ask for her help.
Do you know what? Even my your standards, that is pathetic. All she'll do is run on screaming, "Where is she? Where is she? Where's that nasty witch?" And then she gives the last advice, since the Queen told me to put Preparation H and Deep Heat next to each other in the bathroom.
We are all a bit down in the dumps, aren't we?
Yeah, how about we sing a song to cheer ourselves up?
Yeah. Help! I need somebody, help! Not just anybody, help! You know I need someone.
Light of this little note, I think Plop's plan is worth a try.
Ah, yes. Well, we know how to call Betty, don't we?
Yes!
I think straight into it this time. 1, 2, 3!
Young Betty!
Where is she?
Let me out!
Sorry to disturb you, Betty, but I've told you, we're not at home to Mr. False Alarm. Have you heard the story of the boy who cried wolf?
No.
Well, you should, it's rather good. Now, what menial task have you summoned me for today? I was busy standing my pergola.
We need some advice.
Oh. What goes air? A sheep with no limbs.
Right, so what you need to do is send you off into the castle to find out what's going on.
Hang on. I don't wish to rain on your barbecue, but you want to use plop?
What's wrong with that?
Well, I'm not saying he lacks intelligence, but the last time we went to war with the Kingdom of Silso, and I shouted out, "Get the infantry," Plop came back with a list of everything in my cupboards.
He's perfect. He can act innocent without trying. Now, Plop, I'm going to turn myself into a hamster. I want you to put me in your pocket so that if you get caught, I can still get information out of the castle.
But if I get caught, won't I be locked in a big, smelly, damp, dark dungeon forever?
Yes.
Fair enough.
Okay, we're off to Hoffman, the bad witch of the South's castle. Now you won't forget to boo when you see her, will you?
No! No.
See you later!
Bye!
Well, we need to find out what the witch's plan is so I can get my castle back, my daughter back, and all my lovely money back.
You want a moon on a stick, you do!
Oh, a moon on a stick? How cool would that be?
Oh!
Just the chorus and the da 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 da. I hope you know it.
Okay. And then we'll walk by.
If you castle, and I'm the only one with a castle. I've sent this telegram to the stupid ex-king and queen to tell them.
Well, what happened to their castle?
Well, a huge tangle vine has grown round theirs, and they can't get in. So that officially makes me queen.
Okay then, Your Highness. So, what new laws are you going to introduce then? Free cat food? Well, actually, I don't really need any at the moment. I have this fish.
Where did you get that from?
Never you mind.
Okay, so I'm going to introduce Kiss Someone with a Big Nose Day. And the milkman to deliver twice as much as half the price.
Well, I've just had a little drinking competition with the cat next door.
Oh, did you win?
Yes, I won by 2 laps.
You're boring me now. It's time for me to go and make myself look beautiful for my coronation.
Old Trout!
Pardon?
This fish is an old trout. It's off. He's trying to poison me. Look, I found Block in the wardrobe.
Oh, what did I tell you about using your little trout?
No, his name is Block. He is the king's court master.
You've certainly been caught, master.
I was just checking your hinges. It's National Hinge Week.
Stand still, man! Now, what possible reason could there be for you to be in my castle?
I'll never tell.
We'd have to use a bit of force then.
Okay, I'll tell you everything.
I'm listening.
Well, I'm spying on you to find out what plans you have for the kingdom. When I use my fortune telling powers, all I can see
was
the sleep and when I use my fortune telling powers, all I could see was the prince asleep.
And you have fortune telling powers?
Yes. But I can only use them for good.
Right, foretell what I'm going to do next.
You're not tickling me there!
Oh, thank you. With these powers, I will truly be queen of the world!
What do you mean?
Well, she means that if you can tell the future, then she will be able to know about any threat to her throne, you can tell her. Then she will be able to produce a contingency plan.
Silence, fools!
And yes, I did get covered with a bottle of intelligence juice as well.
Plot, I will use your fortune-telling powers to predict if anybody is going to kiss the princess, and I'll be able to stop them before they get there. Therefore, she will never be rescued.
Cigarettes, well busted and your dad is strong.
Pat!
Yes?
Who's queen?
A successful rock band from the 70s. Not just someone herself.
No, it's me. So be quiet. Right, you weird little person. Get to predicting so I can get kidnapping. You say, Cat?
I'm invincible!
No, you're not. We can see you.
I'm invincible, not invisible. I am invincible.
Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am.
Forfeit, thine armies have fallen. Thou shalt never return to these lands in the time of our new King Richard.
Those aren't your lines. This isn't the Royal Shakespeare Company, this is Malden Players.
I know, it's getting into the classical mood.
Classically bizarre.
Oh, should I do an accent? Scottish?
Ah, no! My name's McGill!
No, you can't say that. You have to say the Scottish play is bad luck for actors. Well, I suppose that means it won't be bad luck for you, will it?
Oh, what do you mean?
Nothing. I take it this year's pantomime's been cast. What part did I get?
Oh, you've got the man Jack sees on the way to the market. She got given some magic beans for a cow or something, I don't know.
It's better than last year, I suppose. Do I have any lines?
Yes, yeah, that's all I got, yes.
Fine. What did you get?
I got an extremely important and pivotal role that requires unyielding deportment and stage dexterity. The name of my part is featured in the title of the show. Pretty cool, eh?
Right, okay. Yeah. So you've got Jack, then?
No!
I'm the beanstalk! What do you think? What budget went up?
Please proceed.
Before you do, can I just ask, did you get part in this year's pantomime?
Of course we have. He wants always part. Unfortunately, you might pass your sell by day when it comes to being here.
Thank you.
Pardon?
The advert!
Well, it went in again today, but I've had no replies.
Is it the same one we've had all week?
No, I changed the wording slightly. It now says, single, bored, fancy doing a bit of gardening. then call this number for a night of chopping up vines, followed by snogging a princess.
What did the old advert say?
Prince wanted to save princess from eternal sleep, must have large... sword.
Oh, no, wasn't married.
And you didn't get any replies?
No, I don't understand it.
I have lots of letters here, sire. This one's from the King of Westerning. I write to ask where my son, the Prince, has got to. He left to rescue your daughter last week, and we haven't seen him since. Oh, here's one from the Queen of Millbrook. I write in a most concerned manner, as my son, the Prince, left a week ago concerning rescuing your daughter from the tower. I am most concerned that something has happened to him, and this concerns me. Yours concerned, the Queen of Millbrook. There are quite a few more, sire.
Do you think she might be concerned in any way?
Maybe.
Well, you know, this is strange because Betty and Plop have been missing for a week now. Maybe there's some sort of black hole or vortex thing going on.
Oh, stop it, Jeff. You're not Doctor Who. There must be a perfectly logical explanation for this X-Files type of behaviour.
Larger than life.
Wake her up, doesn't it?
Yes, but remember, if we do have any intention of kissing her, then surely Plot would have told it and the witch would have already tried and stopped us.
I'm getting so confused. What do you think we should do?
Kiss her! Kiss her!
Oh, you're all saying different things. I'm gonna kiss her.
What?
Finally, kiss the princess!
Yay! Yeah.
I knew you had a skeleton in the closet.
Nah, that's last year's hide-and-seek champion.
But we love the princess.
Aww. Yeah. Aww. We've fancied her since we were small.
You still are small, boys. Now, don't worry. Once this is all over, we'll go home and I can knit you some more foot jumpers.
Whoopee!
Yes, that makes up for a den.
Should I kiss the princess, boys and girls?
Yes!
and now I think I'll be all right. That's so funny. Good Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. We hope you have enjoyed our performance. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's been fun putting it on, has it not?
Yes.
Yes. It's been fun putting it up, hasn't it, yet?
Yes.
Yes. But of course, as always, we couldn't do it without you coming to support us. That is vital. But there are also a huge amount of people behind the scenes, who without them it definitely wouldn't happen, and we do want to thank them. But I would like to say there are a number of new people this year, and without them turning up and saying, yeah, look, I'll get involved, I want to be on stage, I want to sing, I want to put stuff on my face and look like this. Whether they'll be back, I don't know. But really would like to thank them as well. But there are some real key people. I would like to say, you know, all these wonderful costumes, a lot of them have to be fitted. therefore, there's an awful lot of work for that to happen. And Norma Henderson, Helen Robinson, Alison Quinn, Maxine Tocco, Lindsay Vickers have done a wonderful job. Go. If you come and see us, then you definitely probably want your money back. And our Bront was thinking, oh my god, I'm going to be needed every night, most of it. But I think, thankfully, we haven't had to use her. But you've got to have someone in the wings. So Alison Quinn as Bront. Special effects, all those wonderful sounds at the back of the room there, Mark and Nick behind there. To help us stay in key, even though sometimes it's impossible, but some songs they're meant to be out of key, that adds to the pantomime effect. But the man down there, Ron Chimes, year in, year out, Ron Chimes. Wonderful scenery, Marion Hines, Zoe Bart, Ben Taylor, working endless hours to get this thing done. All of our props, very much the same people who did all of our wardrobe, Marion, Lindsay, Norma and Maxine. Again, thank you so much. Two gentlemen, father and son, behind doing all of the stage management, and there are some real heavy lifting stuff going on there, and to be honest, I know they do it, but Mark and Phil Allen, thank you so much. And then finally, there has to be a couple of people who have a vision. Whether this was it, because this is not how it got sold to me. However, you know, yeah, they did this in probably a record time for this because we had a bit of a slow start, we weren't sure we were going to put one on, then we did, so we probably missed a month, and that was crucial, but they've kept the faith, and firstly I'd like to ask our producer Maxine Tocco to come up. Someone said, you know what, I could do this. And she's not signed up for next year. So while she has done it, it does take a lot out of you. It's a phenomenal amount of time and effort to put into something like this. And they have to think it, they have to eat it, they have to live it. And Lindsay Vickers, what a fantastic director. And Tom. It is done. time of us to bid you farewell, but I think we'll go out with one more little boogie.
Yes.
Yeah? Hit it, maestro.